Hey guys, Balkan Architect here, and as you can see, I'm really excited today because finally, after a year of work, it's finally done. The Revit Materials Masterclass, it's available now on BalkanArchitect.com. So this is a course on, well, as the name would imply, materials inside of Revit. So I've been working on this for a long time because I wanted to kind of explore everything that there is to know about materials in Revit in depth and then present that as a course. So as I said, it's available now. You can find it by following the first link in the description just below this video, and then also by clicking on the cards above. Now for this course, I cover everything that you need to know about materials in Revit. Most excitingly, I'm going to be showing you how to actually go out with your phone or your camera, take a photo of a material in nature or at a building site or wherever, and then how you can transform that photo, how you can adjust the image, make it seamless, generate all of the maps, and then assemble that as a material inside of Revit that actually looks like the real thing that you've taken a photograph of. So I think this is really exciting, and also all of this is PBR materials. So with Revit, with the latest few versions, we finally have PBR materials. PBR stands for physically based rendering. Basically, this is kind of a more advanced approach to creating materials. If you've ever played those video games that have that really good graphics, or if you watch some special effects in movies, usually they use these types of physically based materials. They're now finally available inside of Revit, and I'm going to be showing you exactly how you can create these materials in this course. Also, of course, in the course, we're going to be covering how to create numerous kind of basic Revit materials, regular Revit materials, but also the more advanced ones. We have numerous different projects that approach different types of materials, so we're going to be covering everything. Brick, stone, wood, tile, glass, chain link fence, even glowing materials, even that's covered in the course. So the entire course is 6.5 hours long. It's divided into 5 chapters. We start off with the basics, we explore the concepts, and just develop an understanding of how Revit looks at materials, how it looks at different types of assets. I think this can be really confusing, so we explore all of that in depth. Then we move on and create all sorts of different materials. We're also going to be covering scheduling of materials and all of the parameters that can be associated with materials, and then how to set those up and how to schedule that later. And then finally, we're going to be talking about actually applying materials inside of Revit. So how can you properly map materials on your surfaces, how to set up the position and rotation of the material, how to set up its scale, of course, how does Revit look at materials on curved surfaces? This can be really annoying, so we cover that as well. And then also how you can utilize decals to make some unique solutions for particular problems or for particular kind of presentation that you want to achieve. I think decals are really powerful. They tend to be, well, not used that much, but I think they're really powerful and they should be utilized more. So we cover how to kind of use them properly. So as I said, it's available on my website. So that's first link just below this video in the description, or click on the link in the cards above. If you're interested, please check it out. And of course, I'll be back in a few days with another regular Balkan Architect tutorial. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.